So you're looking to find out the pricing factors for insulating your rim joist? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be discussing the factors that go into pricing out your rim joist with spray foam insulation. Before we get into that, please go down below and hit that like button for us. Thanks. So the first thing that we're going to be looking at in your rim joist is there existing insulation that needs to be removed? Typically, there's fiberglass stuffed up into a rim joist, and we always have to take that out before spray foam is applied. This obviously will add time, tools, and material needed, and obviously this will add cost to your overall project. So the first thing you look at is there existing insulation that needs to be removed? So the next thing that we want to look at when we're pricing out your rim joist is the accessibility. Some basements can be sealed off with a drop ceiling system or even drywall. So in some of those cases, if it's just a drop ceiling, those tiles a lot of times can be simply moved out of the way. However, if your basement is finished off with drywall, that will involve cutting into the drywall, removing any insulation that's in there, and then obviously some type of patchwork will have to happen to replace that drywall that was cut out. If that's the case, obviously that can add time and cost to your project. So keep that in mind if your rim joist is not easily accessible. Now the truth is that most rim joist projects will fall into a minimum charge, which for us is around $1,500. But the safe thing to do is to go onto our website and use our budget calculator, plug in the information about your project so that you can get a budget range on what your specific rim joist would be. If you want to learn more about the pricing factors for insulating your rim joist, check out the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.